You name a name and we'll tell you if we worked with them.
Did you perform with Sinatra? Yeah.
Yes.
And Sammy Davis?
Yes.
Dean Martin?
Yes.
Elvis?
Yes.
I'll tell you a story.
Elvis
about
Lucille
Vegas? Ball.
I'll tell you about Elvis.
John Wayne. I mean, it's crazy. It really is nuts.
Ethel Merman.
I went to go see Elvis Presley, his last show, or his closing night show, I should say, at the Hilton. And we were opening up the next night. And I remember watching the king on stage. He could do no wrong. I mean, the audience was in the palm of his hand. The next night, I'm in his dressing room with my brothers, getting ready. And the door opens up. Hi, everybody. I'm Elvis Presley. And he's really talk like this, too. And he's just want to come say hi and good luck. And
it's my brother.
I thought, how cool is that? The king of rock and roll just walked through the door. And he's a real person. It taught me a lot about leaving the star on stage. When you go off stage, you're just another person. And it really put the whole show business.
It was their job.
What else made those guys the best?
They worked.
I think they didn't look at it as being a celebrity. They looked at it as being an entertainer. It was their job, and it was every day. How do I be better? How do I get? I mean, they love that audience. We love our audiences. We want them to leave feeling that, you know what, it's an expensive ticket. It's not as expensive as some of them here. But when they leave, they got their money's worth. They had an experience. They had something that brought them back to some kind of memory, whether it was way back the Donny and Marie original shows or whether it was a current something they saw from like Dancing with the Stars or whatever. They walk away feeling that they got to know us better.
Here's another thing, Piers. Sometimes I feel like entertainers, young entertainers that jump into the business, get a lot of fame and
fortune.
Wait
a minute, we're young.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
actually look ridiculously young. Well, I'm going to come to this in a moment.
But so many people,
I don't know how you've done this.
So many people feel entitled. You know, I'm on stage, you need to like me. Well, yeah, there's that attitude, that confidence on stage, but they forget about getting out there and working and doing all those little gigs, 366 days a year, going through the work, going through the motions.
So being a proper star, really, from what you're saying, is looking out to an audience and making them feel as important as they're making you feel.
Absolutely. And you know, and
I don't
what he said
that in so many of the new acts.
But what he said,
that.
Though, that's really crucial is, I mean, I remember Milton Berle, the first time I worked with him, and he came on and they took a script and he just started slashing, no, this won't work in this, and he worked to make that silly little 3-minute sketch brilliant. And it wasn't just, oh, that's okay. Well, the writers, he worked with the writers. He worked. It was a constant effort by the people we got to work with to
remember,
make everything the best it could be, even if it was a stupid sketch, which usually it was on our show.
Do you remember what Groucho Marx did to you?
Yeah.
Okay. This guy, dirty old man.
Groucho Marx?
Groucho Marx.
Pinched my butt.
It was pinching Marie's butt the whole time.
Seriously?
He was on the Donny and Marie show, and yeah, dirty
I mean,
old
how
man.
Many people
well,
get to say they were
with
Groucho?
Line. Wasn't it Groucho that said, you're only as old as the woman you feel?
Oh, I love
that's
that.
That's Groucho.
I've never heard that one, but that is perfect.
And I would have been 14 and a half.
Yeah.
No, 15.
So this was completely inappropriate.
Which would have been illegal.
Yeah.
Now
good old Groucho. They don't make him him anymore, do they? What was John Wayne like?
John Wayne was a very stoic man.
Tall.
And just
sweet.
He talked like this, really.
He was,
you know,
he was John
well,
Wayne.
I'm doing a lot of impressions.
You're very good.
Well, thank you, kid.